Disney Winnie the Pooh. Story adaptation by Nancy Parent. Illustrations by the Disney Storybook Artists. Copyright 2011 Disney Enterprises. This is the story of how Winnie the Pooh and his friends in the Hundred Acre Wood tried to help Eeyore find a tail. They discovered that helping isn't always easy. One morning, Winnie the Pooh and his rumbly tumbly woke up to find all their honey pots were empty. Now, this was rather bothersome to Pooh and his tummy, so Pooh went into the Hundred Acre Wood to find some honey. Pooh soon came upon his friend Eeyore. Sadly, Eeyore didn't have any honey. He didn't even have any tail either. Wanting to help, Pooh declared, "I will find your tail, then I shall get some honey." Just then, the friends heard Owl's voice drifting. Down, down, when Owl heard about Eeyore's missing tail, he wanted to help too. So the three friends went to find Christopher Robin. Everyone soon gathered at the boy's house, and he announced a contest. Whoever found a suitable tail for Eeyore would win a delicious pot of honey. Pooh was very excited to help Eeyore and win the prize honey for his tummy. He thought perhaps his poo-coo clock might make a perfect tail for Eeyore. And so it did, until Eeyore sat down. Piglet offered Eeyore, his friend, Beloon, as a tail, but it didn't work quite as well as expected. "It's okay," mumbled Eeyore, after trying out several more tails. "I'll learn to live without it." Afterward, Pooh continued his search for honey. He stopped at Christopher Robin's house, but the boy wasn't there. But there was a note, which Pooh took to Owl. Owl helpfully read the boy's note out loud. "Gone out. Busy. Back sun. Signed, Christopher Robin." Owl gasped. "Our dear friend Christopher Robin has been captured by a creature called the Back Sun." Then Owl explained it's malicious, ferocious, and worst of all, terribly busy. Then he drew a picture of a horrible monster with shaggy fur and sharp horns. Rabbit quickly came up with a plan that he thought might help. They would collect things that the Backson might like and leave a trail of them, leading the Backson into a deep pit. And when the Backson fell into the trap, they would be able to get Christopher Robin back. While everyone collected the Backson things, Pooh and Piglet dug a hole and covered it. Meanwhile, Tigger tried to help by catching the Backson on his own. He soon came upon an unsuspecting Eeyore. "You and me are going to catch that Backson," declared Tigger. "We just need to get you Tigger-sized." "Looking great," said Tigger, admiring his work. Then, because ears are bouncy, he showed Eeyore how to bounce. Up and down, but mostly up. Next, Tigger dressed up like a Backson that Eeyore could practice sneaking up on. But Eeyore had soon had enough. Tiggerizing, he bounced away and hid. Tigger searched everywhere for Eeyore, but could only find his springy tail. "The Backsons must have found Eeyore," Tigger thought. He didn't realize that Eeyore didn't want to be found by a Backson or by a Tigger. Meanwhile, Pooh and his friends headed for the Backson trap. But Pooh's tummy was so hungry that he began seeing honeypots everywhere. Suddenly, Pooh spotted a real honeypot in the middle of a picnic blanket. His rumbly tummy had made Pooh forget that the honeypot on the picnic blanket was really a Backson trap. Whoosh! Pooh fell into the trap, landing with a thud. "We caught the Backson!" exclaimed Rabbit upon seeing the trap. But the friends soon discovered that the Baxen was actually a Pooh Bear. Just then, Eeyore arrived wearing an anchor as his tail. Wanting to help, Rabbit suggested they could use the anchor to rescue Pooh. But when they threw it into the pit, it dragged them in too, all except Piglet. Rabbit suggested that Piglet go to Christopher Robin's house and bring back his jump rope to pull them out. Little Piglet was rather nervous, but he wanted to help, so he ventured into the dark wood. Suddenly, he saw a red-eyed monster, but it was only Beloon stuck in a tree. Piglet freed Beloon, just as an enormous shadow fell over them. "Baxen!" Piglet stammered. It wasn't the Baxen, though, only Tigger. Piglet was in such a hurry to get away that he let Beloon sail up, up, up into the air, with Tigger following. Soon, Piglet had spotted the pit down below. Then he bumped into the giant words from his very own storybook. Down into the pit, the friends tumbled, along with all the letters. Now everyone was stuck, so Owl began to tell a story. Then Beloon floated away, and the friends thought they would never get out. Luckily, Pooh noticed a honeypot at the edge of the pit. Using the letters around him, the hungry bear built a ladder and climbed out. Unfortunately for Pooh and his tummy, the honeypot was empty. He tossed the pot away, and it landed with a thump right on Owl's head. Just then, Rabbit noticed Pooh's letter ladder. "We can get out!" he cried. Outside the pit, the friends discovered Christopher Robin and Beloon. "How did you escape the Baxen?" asked Rabbit. But Christopher Robin didn't even know what a Baxen was. After Pooh showed him the note, Christopher Robin explained that he had written "back soon," not "Baxen." It had been a silly misunderstanding. Everyone headed home. On the way, Pooh stopped at Owl's, hoping to find honey there. As he tugged on Owl's bell rope, he thought there was something familiar about it. Owl explained that no one seemed to want the rope because he had found it hanging over a thistle. "Somebody did want it, Owl," said Pooh. "Eeyore," Owl agreed. "I was just keeping it safe for him." So Pooh took the tail to Eeyore without eating so much as a smackerel of honey. Everyone watched Eeyore try on his tail. "Pink bows, a nice touch," he decided. "Swishes real good, too." "Bring out the grand prize," shouted Christopher Robin, presenting Pooh with an enormous pot of honey. So, in the end, Winnie the Pooh put his friend before his tummy and helped Eeyore. And though it wasn't easy, Pooh found that helping was the sweetest reward of all. Next to honey, that is. A sweet ending. Pooh helped Eeyore find his tail. Now look back in the book and help Pooh find 5 honeypots in a chair. 4 large rocks in a square. 3 yellow spots on a clown. 2 silly friends tumbling down. 1 happy Pooh after he's won. Now the counting fun is done.
Christopher's childhood days.